The delay hands off to Nye Brown. Again, Loyola can't seem to get into the middle. Kick back to Cruzin. Cruzin lets it rip. Nothing but net. Nicole Cruzin with a three-ball splashdown. And that's good enough to tie us up at six. Nye Brown gets a ball screen from Tiffany Paget. Now kicks it back to Paget. Paget now near side, Lisa Mararki. Here's Afidele, pulls up, beautiful looking jumper, drops the 14-footer, and we're tied up at 8. Drops it off for Dougherty. Dougherty looking for Mararki, poor pass by the freshman. Another turnover for Loyola, they've got 3 now. And we go back the other way, little left-handed scoop there by Claire Marie O'Brien.
So 2 6-footers on the floor for Bucknell, not one for Loyola. We'll see how the rebounding is affected.
Nice screen and roll. Nye Brown didn't give it up, she kept it, made the easy runner in the lane, and it's a 10-10 tie. Fresh shot clock here. Nice interior passing once again. Soon a Swart has it. Now there's a long distance jumper, nothing but net. A three ball by Claire Marie O'Brien and a 13-10 lead for the Bison. Dougherty gets it back to Janae Perry. Perry spins into trouble. Finds Mararki on the far side wing. Now Mararki near side to Paget. Paget looking to do work. Jump stop. She'll pull up. Drops it at the buzzer, and a good possession there by Loyola. Rock solid effort.
Again, I credit our kids. You know, they're in the gym. They're really staying the course. We haven't seen the results, but, you know, I get to see them every day in practice. So I see them make those shots, and I couldn't be happier or prouder of them that hard work in practice is starting to pay off. They're in there extra and just accepting what comes their way. You know, tonight we were able to start Cruzin. Just a better matchup for us. Tiff had to go back into the post. So, you know, I think we're versatile. And I think as we keep progressing, we're getting better every night, and eventually we are going to start to see some better results.
Long-range jumper, no good there. McGurk had a good look, couldn't knock it down. Offensive rebound for Bucknell. Bison back in attack mode. Nice bounce pass. Dodson working free along that baseline. He gets a beautiful pass from Shelby Romine. Now here's Nye Brown to Cruzin. Cruzin to Tiffany Paget. Paget looking inside, can't find anyone, now uses her dribble. Nice pass off the backside to Nicole Cruzin, who was working fantastic without the basketball. Her layup is good, and it's a 40-37 lead now for Bucknell. Bucknell extends the defense now. Nicole needs some help. Poor pass, well defended and taken away by Shelby Romine. Romine working on the baseline, gives it up to Dodson. Nice little shovel pass, and Dodson makes another easy layup. Back up top to McGurk. McGurk now near side to Romine. Romine gets cut off nicely by Cruz and an off and delay. Once again, Dodson wide open. Not sure how she comes open like that. She's got to be a focal point for the Hounds defensively. Nye Brown to off and delay. Now Necka sets a pick. Brown works it, gets into the paint, gets up high with the basketball. Nice power move there by Nye Brown as she attacks the rack, and it's a three-point game. Nye dumps down into the high post. Necka off and delay. She'll give it up to Nye Brown. Sets a ball screen. Brown maintains her dribble. Fires it over to Mararki. Mararki to Paget. Paget lets it go. Beautiful looking stroke there, and Paget drops the long range jumper. It's a 1-point ball game. Loyola looks to spread the floor here. Brown spins into the lane, pulls up from 8 feet, rattles it down. Nice move by Nye Brown, and it's a tie ball game, 51-51. Ball goes towards the middle. Dodson has it top of the foul line. She'll pass to the wing. Romine's runner off the glass. Count it. That's a big bucket there by Bucknell, and they re-extend 59-55, just 50 seconds left.
Bucknell plays at a tremendous pace, which you saw in the second half. And we did not want to play at that pace for a lot of reasons. But we did a good job in the first half, but credit them. Second half, you know, they got going a little bit more. We missed some more shots, and they were able to get out and run. So really wanted to slow them down a little bit, but they were able to get out and run. But even that being said, you know, I thought it was a great game. We're right there at the end of 4-minute timeout. I think it was tied, and then it just kind of got away from us a little bit. But, you know, I'm really happy with our progress. I told our kids after the game I couldn't be prouder of our effort. And, you know, we keep playing like that, we're going to be okay. You know, it's all about March, but, you know, we're still trying to position ourselves for that tournament at the end of the season.